was looking for you, Arthur. He's over by the tree behind the campfire.
He was?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thank you, Miss Grimshaw.
All city for Hershey and all. All my world traveling and rolling.
How is it? Even piercing sauce gets stuck in your teeth.
You got food, health, warmth. Be grateful for that. Hey, Arthur!
What do you want?
Uncle told me something about a train.
What did he say?
Mary Beth overheard something about a train full of wealthy folk rolling down through Scarlet Meadows just south of the state border?
Yes.
Need help with it?
I ain't even sure about doing it.
Come on. At night, not too guarded, it's perfect.
Nah, I ain't thought it through. You know, stopping a train, pain in the ass.
Sure. But what if we could force a train to stop?
Well, of course.
We get a wagon full of something flammable, oil. Put it on the tracks. They see it. They know they either have to stop or die. Ain't no train driver wants to be cooked alive.
That kind of brilliant. For you. That is a real idea. I think that's the first time you ever had one of them.
Shut up.
You might be the first bastard to ever have half his brains eaten by a wolf and end up more intelligent.
So we're doing it?
Yeah, we're gonna need ammunition, guns, look real frightening, and some dynamite to open up the train.
I'll get the supplies. Gotta head into town for Abigail anyway. Don't even ask. You go find us an oil wagon.
Yeah, I know just the place. They're always heading into that refinery.
There's an old rundown shack just over the border, north of a place called Dewberry Creek. Leave it hidden somewhere near there.
Living free out here? Like this? I wouldn't have it any other way.
You got a good head on you, kid. Morgan? Morgan?
Good morning, Arthur.
You okay?
Yeah, just fed up with all the pessimism around here.
Good morning.
Morning, mister.
Okay, boy. Let's go. Ready?
This ain't a public attraction. Move along.
Take this!
Yeah. strike your piece. You're dead. Stop right there. You'll be all right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Send you? Because if they did, they can get lost. I have never been so insulted in all my life. Really, laughed at. Balderdash. Are you quite certain you're not a spy? Those wretches will do anything to destroy me. My theories are correct, and I can prove it. I am the leading amateur paleontologist in the nation, and not one university will hire me because, unlike them, I actually have ideas.
You're a what?
I study dinosaurs. You know, big lizards.
Are they real?
Of course they're real, you nincompoop. And everywhere.
Everywhere?
This state was once a vast, shallow sea that had the most incredible animal that could walk, swim, and fly. Quite unique. I call it Totalosaurus. Just for now. I'm trying to gather all the evidence. Miss Deborah McGinnis?
Arthur.
Good to meet you. Could you give me a hand here, please?
Of course.
Yeah. Listen. If you find any of these bones around the country, send them to my homestead at Furwood Rise in Cumberland Forest. Or mail me the locations. I'll reward you handsomely for your efforts.
Sure. Why not?
And we'll be proving a lot of stuck-up buffoons very, very wrong. Which, trust me, is the very best thing about science. Good day to you, sir.
Good luck. I'll keep my eye out for you.
The bigger they are, the harder they fall.
Damn it! Damn all you!
You stalking me too, Arthur.
You getting crazy, Dutch?
I've always been.
Before you come any closer, the answer is no.
What did I want?
You wanted money. Just a little. Just a little.
You already owe me a lot.
I am not well. I think I'm dying. I need...
Just in time, Mr. Morgan.
If you are dying, how do you plan to repay me?
Thank you, Arthur.
Oh, you are a heartless little swine. You really are.
Howdy do, Arthur.
John?
Let's get on.
Good. And you?
Got everything we need.
Good. I think we need another man. Charles?
I'll go get him. Meet us at the wagon when you can.
Sure.
See you, Arthur. Ain't that dumb.
Next time, let the wolves eat all your brain. Then you'll be a genius.
Mr. Morgan, whatever did happen with that Mary Gillis?
It all came to nothing, Miss Grimshaw.
That's for the best.
Sure, of course.
I never did like her very much.
Hello, Arthur.
Let's go, girl.
You ever let this horse feed? I got space for you if you need stabling.
That don't surprise me none.
I can give it a good home.
Want some, huh?
Sure, I'll shoot you. I wouldn't mind some practice.
Well, let's get to it then.
Come, look at this.
All right, come on.
You got this.
Wouldn't believe it unless I'd seen it.
Hello there. Here for the show?
Yep.
Some money and find ourselves an escape route, same as usual. But we are making money. And we will find an escape. We are gonna be okay.
I agree. We get some big money and get lost.
Hi, Arthur. Come here a minute.
What is it?
Can I ask you a favor?
Probably not.
Very funny. Would you do something with Jack? He seems kind of down. All this upheaval can't have been easy on the poor kid.
Why? Because I'm your preferred nursemaid?
Because he likes you, and, well, you know his father's useless.
Okay.
Thank you.
What you up to?
Playing.
Anything fun?
I guess.
You want to come fishing with me?
Fishing?
Sure. You're right. It's about time that you started to earn your keep.
Okay.
Good. Let's go get your pole then. Now, you do have a fishing pole, don't you?
I sure do. Uncle Jose made me one.
Good. Well, let's go get it then. Go catch us some fish.
Yeah.
I'll mount up and lift you on when you're ready.
I will.
All right. Hold on tight.
So, where are we going?
Just down to the river near here. We shouldn't go too far from camp.
Oh, okay.
You feeling better? I know you was a little sick.
Oh, I'm fine.
You're a brave kid.
So, just like you.
Well, I don't know about brave. I ain't much of a kid no more. Though your mama might disagree. Her and a few other women, I guess.
What do you mean?
I'm just talking silly. It's been a tough few weeks up in that snow.
I like the snow.
Yes, but not like that.
When are we going back to the other camp?
The one near Blackwater?
Yeah.
Well, we're not. This is our spot. For now, anyway. Why?
I forgot a storybook there. We left so quick.
Well, I'm sure someone can get you another storybook.
Really? When?
Well, we'll see. Got fish to catch first. All right, this looks as good a spot as any.
Where should we stand, Uncle Arthur?
Down by the shore. Come on, follow me.
I can't wait to get started. You show me where, Uncle Arthur. Are you waiting for something?
First, we need some bait. I'm gonna use some cheese.
Cheese?
Smellier the better. Now, cast your line. Swing the rod back over your shoulder and bring it forward in a smooth motion. Use your wrist, not your elbow.
Like that?
That's it. Good. All we do now, Jack, is wait for a fish to take the bait.
How do I know when I've got a bite?
Well, if you feel the tip of your fishing rod just twitching, don't yank it yet. That just means one's nibbling. If you feel a hard tug, that's a fish going for the bait, so yank hard to hook it.
This is a great fishing spot.
Don't jinx it, kid.
I think you've got a bite. Look.
There we go.
Pull him in.
You see him fighting there, Jack? That's when you gotta be careful. You'll break the line. Best to wear him out first before you try to reel him in. Well, seems like he's taking a rest now. I'm gonna try reeling him in nice and steady. You okay there?
I think so. This is hard. Why am I not catching any?
Just be patient.
My arms are tired.
You're all right. You know, this reminds me. I taught another boy to fish once. Long time ago.
You mean Lenny?
No. No, this was long before I met Lenny. Long before you was even born. Look, Jack, it's a bluegill. It's almost as small as you.
We should really throw these smaller ones back. Give them a chance to grow up a bit.
Can I take a break from fishing? I want to make something.
Okay.
I'm gonna pick some of those red flowers. I'll be right back.
Cast, Jack? You gotta stick at things, Jack. Fish on the line.
Is it a big one?
Well, this is clearly the spot for bluegill.
Sure is boring, Uncle Arthur.
I know. Boring as hell. But then, something happens. And you can get food for days.
Really?
If you're lucky. But until then, you just sit, wait, try not to worry. It's good for you.
It's good for you?
I guess.
Huh. Hey, look at this.
And what?
This necklace I made.
Necklace?
For Mama.
Sure.
What a fine young man. And in such complex circumstances. Arthur, isn't it? Arthur Morgan?
Who are you?
Yes, Arthur Morgan. Vanderlyn's most trusted associate. You've read the files. Typical case. Orphaned street kid seduced by that maniac's silver tongue and matures into a degenerate murderer. Agent Milton, Agent Ross, Pinkerton Detective Agency, seconded to the United States government. Nice to finally meet. We know a lot about you.
Do you?
You're a wanted man, Mr. Morgan. There's $5,000 for your head alone.
$5,000? For me? Can I turn myself in?
We want Vanderlyn.
Old Dutch. I haven't seen him for months.
That's so. Because I heard a guy fitting his description robbed a train belonging to Leviticus Cornwall up near Granite Pass.
Oh, ain't that a little old-fashioned nowadays?
Apparently not. Listen. This is my offer, Mr. Morgan. Bring in Vanderlyn. You have my word, you won't swing.
Oh, I ain't gonna swing anyways, Agent.
Milton.
You see, I haven't done anything wrong, aside from not playing the games to your rules.
Spare me the philosophy lesson. I've already heard it from Mac Callender.
Mac Callender?
He was pretty shot up by the time I got to him. So really, it was more of a mercy killing. Slow. But merciful.
You enjoy being a rich man's toy, dear.
I enjoy society, flaws and all. You people venerate savagery, and you will die. Savagely, all of you.
Oh, we're all gonna die, Agent.
Some of us sooner than others. Good day, Mr. Morgan.
Goodbye.
Enjoy your fishing, kid, while you still can.
Who are they?
No one to worry about. No one at all. Come on, let's pick up your things and get home. It's getting late, Jack. Your mother'll be worried. Let's head back.
Are you taking me back? Why did you lie about where Uncle Dutch is?
Because... well... because those are disagreeable men. And I don't want them to hurt him.
What did they mean about Matt? Is he in jail?
No, I don't think so. I hope he's just fine where he is. Like I said, don't worry about them. The world is full of disagreeable men. That's why you got all of us to protect you. Folk like them. Now, how about that necklace you made? You still got it, right?
Yeah, I got it.
Good. Fishing?
It was okay, I think. It's a lot of weight around.
It is. Yeah.
Great! We caught a fish, and I made you this necklace.
Ain't that pretty? Ain't I the luckiest? Did you thank Uncle Arthur?
No, Nate. We had a good time.
What's wrong?
Nothing. Just met some folk. I better go speak with Dutch.
Okay.
Hey, you did real fine, kid.
Thanks.
We got a problem.
What?
I just met some guys out near the river. A fella named, Milton, and, I don't remember the other fella's name. Ross. Milton and Ross.
And
they are employees of the Pinkerton Detective Agency. And they know about the train, and they know we're here.
Were you followed back here?
No. They know we're near here. And they want you, Dutch. They offered me my freedom in exchange, they did.
Why didn't you take it?
Very funny. Well, what do we do now?
I say we do nothing. Just yet. It's just trying to scare us into doing something stupid. We have turned a corner. We survived them mountains. We just need to stay calm.
You saw Pinkerton's, did you?
Saw, met, and got the full message.
What did you think?
I think we're in real trouble, but the only way out is forward.
I know. That Blackwater business seems to have finished us.
So enjoy yourselves. Life is good. Oh, life is good. You hear that, Mr. Pearson?
If I keep sitting here.
Martha.
Hey there, little man. Hi, Mama.
Arthur, my boy.
Reverend.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan, for sparing me like that. I'll work hard. I am not a bad fella. You'll soon warm to me.
Just see that I do.
Oh, you will.
And boy, thank you for saving my life.
Well, yeah, of course.
Hello, Art.